Hello and welcome to Platform Studio. My first video on this channel was a section rendering video in Photoshop. I remember it was 2018 and I feel like that video is outdated, so I wanted to do something new. I wanted to make it a little bit easier. So here I will show you how to render your section in Adobe Photoshop from AutoCAD to Adobe Photoshop. How to turn your section from this to this. First, I will open our AutoCAD file. Here is a section, it's a simple section as this video is for beginners. So first, I will type plot and this will take us to plot command. And if you go to plot command and this window will open up, this is the plot window. Here, at first, you will select the printer or plotter. I'm selecting DWG to PDF and then the paper size. I'm selecting A2 paper size, landscape. Then I'm going to window and I will capture the section here. And then I will go to the scale. Here I'm choosing 1:75 in feet and inches. So this is your raw PDF file, raw section file. Now I have to just save it. Before that I will center the plot to make it centered. Now I will save it as a PDF file. Here, save, and this is our PDF file. This will go into Photoshop for rendering. So now we can close our AutoCAD. Let's open Photoshop. Now here you can just drag the PDF file into Photoshop. Make sure the resolution is 300. Press OK. So here is your PDF file. As you can see, the top is missing because when I imported the PDF file, the Photoshop only captured the boundary box. So I will go to image and canvas size and anchor. I will just click the bottom one and I will increase the height. So if I do that, you will get extra space on top. Now I have to make a background, so I will create a new layer and then you can rename it as background, and then I will fill this background with white color. So go to edit, fill, and white. So here, now let's import our textures. So first I will import the sky. I have a sky here, nice watercolor sky. I will place it like this in the background and I will rasterize the layer. To work with the layer, to cut it, to copy it, if you rasterize it, it's better. So now I will select the section layer, then I will select the magic tool and I will select the bottom part, the earth part. So the earth part, the sectional earth is selected, and now I will go to the sky layer and press CTRL+X. You can do it by layer via cut, but the shortcut is CTRL+X. It's easy, simple. So how can I cut the inside part of this building? So again, go to the section layer, select the sky part, press select, and then select inverse. Now press Alt button and select all the windows at their transparent, so they will be excluded. Yeah. You can now go to the sky and again CTRL+X. So here our windows are transparent, but the opacity should not be same as the background sky. So now I'm again selecting the section, the sky part of the section, and again selecting the inverse, and I'm selecting layer via cut to separate the two layers, the windows, transparent windows, and the background sky. And I will decrease the opacity of the windows like this here. So the basic sky is done. Now let's go to the earth, sectional earth. I will import the texture here and I'll place it like this. It's not covering the whole part, so I will just transform it a little bit like this, and pressing the Alt button I will copy it. It's a seamless texture, but even if it is a seamless texture, when I copy it, you can see a little bit seam as the textures are not aligned. So I will just select the eraser tool and erase the corners to make it seem like the two layers are seamless. Here it is. I will merge two layers, merge layers. So now again with the magic tool, I will select the earth sectional area from the section. Then I will go to the texture and I will select layer via cut, and I will hide the previous layer. So as you can see, the texture is there here. So you can play with the opacity, or you can do some brushworks here. I will just select the burn tool and I will burn the edges a little. You can skip this, it's just your preference. So here it is. Now let's go to the forest background, and I will do the same thing here, the same principle. As our sectional ground line is not flat, so I will just make two copies to make it look like seamless. First I will rasterize this layer. I will cut off this part, CTRL+X, and then I will do layer via copy. So as you can see, it's there, the background. So again I will go to the original source texture and I will duplicate it, and I will move it here, do a little bit transforming. Now again I'm selecting the sky portion and just doing layer via cut. Now I'm selecting the background portion and doing layer via copy again, and I'm deleting the source layer. So here I have composited two layers here, and I will just brush off this edge to make it seamless. So it looks seamless now. So I will again merge two layers, these two layers. So here is our forest or plants background. Now don't forget we have transparent windows here, so the background forest area, the background plants should be visible a little bit. So let's select the window areas, and from the source texture let's copy the texture on the windows. See, but we should decrease the opacity. So here is our forest background done. Now you can leave it like this, or you can add some additional plants. If your design have specific plants or anything, you can add more plants. So I'm adding here some trees. I'm putting this layer in front of the background forest layer, and place it whatever, like wherever you want. So here is our tree. I will bring another one. The second one. So you get the idea how to add trees or plants. So I will fast forward from here. So we have all our trees here. Now let's select them all by pressing the CTRL. Select all the layers of the trees and merge them so that we can manipulate them. Merge all the trees again with the magic tool, and the section layer, select the sky portion, the background portion, and see and cut out the trees from the building portion. I will decrease the opacity a little bit. Again, as you can see, we have transparent windows, so we have the source layer of the trees here. So I will select the windows again with from the section layer. Then I will go to the source layer of the trees, and again layer via copy, and I will hide the source layer, and here it is. So we can see the trees from the transparent windows, and let's decrease the opacity. The opacity here. So our trees are done. So everything follows the same method. If you can catch one method, you will be able to do. You will be able to add textures, any textures. So now we are adding some flying birds, flock of birds. Make sure when you add birds or something like this, it's the scale is relatable, it's not too big or too small. And also decrease the opacity a little bit. So our board is done. Let's add some people. I have some people PNG cutout, silhouettes. We will import them into Photoshop first, and then I will just copy them from here to here, and I will place them appropriately. And bring the layer in front. Always keep in mind when you are adding people or population, always keep it in your mind when you are adding people or population, don't mess up the scale. The scale is important. We add people in sections to give the building or our structure a sense of scale. So if you mess up the scale of the people, the whole section doesn't look good. So when you are adding people, make sure the scale is right, the scale is correct relative to the structure or the building. So it's easy, it's the same process, just copy and paste and scale them, transform them. And I will fast forward from here, I will add a couple more people here. So that's it, that's our section. All the files that I have used are provided in the description. There is a link there, you can download it and you can practice it. Let me know if you learned something from this video. If you like this video, please do subscribe. Please press the notification icon so you don't miss my future videos. Thank you for watching this video. Good luck.